Oh, I guess that's just the way we're going to have to do it. Sadly, for some reason, we cannot get the audio going right. And what she is presenting is that I ask her questions and then just repeat them, get it fixed. But hopefully, we'll have it fixed if something like this happens in the future. So, Kiwi, why don't you tell us a little bit about the PvP dimensions and how they work? Yeah, but I mean, is it just for arena type stuff, or what do you have in mind with the PvP dimensions? What she's basically saying is that you guys can get really creative with it. You can do your arenas like we're about to see just shortly in this event, and also that you can do stuff such as mazes and a lot of other creative stuff to make it really fun for people to visit your dimension and PvP with one another. So, she's saying that it's not just about PvP, you can do it with a lot of things, such as traps and blocking people in, and basically just be as creative as you can with it, and people will have a lot of fun with it. So, now that we are seeing an arena type format like we're about to see in this event, is there any plans to expand on this a little more to give even more control to the players to where we can, I guess, put on events like this without as many issues? Because what we're seeing right off the bat is that we're worrying about a lot of things that can go wrong with this. She's saying that it's basically all up to everybody to be as creative as possible with the tools that are presented to you. And if I'm understanding her correctly, that the more that you use the tools provided to you, the more likely that it will be improved upon. Is that right, Kiwi? Yeah, she's basically saying that it's all community based and it's really fun seeing what people come up with and can't wait to see what's going to be coming up in the future, definitely. All right. So now that we're seeing this kind of, I mean, this is basically the bare bones going into a big fighting event like we're doing. It's not as creative as you're talking about with mazes and stuff just yet, but that stuff will come naturally. But I'm kind of curious, we're seeing that Trine is supporting this kind of tournament with like the codes and stuff like that. Is anything in the future going to be like that to increase promotion of it, or is it just going to be onto the players for the most part? Yeah, she's basically saying that the more this stuff is being used by the players, it's really cool that people are providing their own kind of rewards and running contests like they have in June 2013. And really, this is the kind of stuff that they're looking for, is more use out of the things that they're making, and the more use comes more support for it. Did I get all that right, Kiwi? Yeah, she's just basically chit-chatting about how, you know, the things that are going on with the dimensions and stuff like that. I'm not really too sure how to relay what you just said. So, let's see, what other questions? Ask some questions in the chat so I can repeat them to her and have her answer some of them. Yeah, she's saying that it'd be really cool if people use these PvP dimensions to educate others in PvP and set up, so to say, tutorial type of stuff, I suppose, and just really try to promote PvP altogether and use the dimensions as a tool for that. Yeah, she's saying that on her website they basically tore it apart and put it back together so that in the future there will be tutorials on how to build these PvP dimensions in the best ways possible, I guess. Of course, your creativity will fall into that, but it's basically taking it to a whole nother level, in her words. She's saying that she wants to see this expanded as much as possible and to see the players using it as much as possible. That way you'll get more support and the website will support it as well. Do you have a link to your website that you could give to the players? There's a link, guys, to the website that she was just talking about. One of the questions that they're asking, they're saying that the PvP dimensions are a bit expensive for them in their current state, even with the current 20% discount. Do you have any kind of comment on that, or? She's saying that they put a year's worth of work into this and that the price isn't really too extreme whenever you think about how much effort and how vast that this can become if you guys put the effort and the creativity into it. It can keep expanding and be well worth the money. Yeah, she's saying that it's made to be a group project, as in four or five people just get together, split the cost, and have a lot of fun with these dimensions. It'll make it a lot more affordable on each and every one of you. So let's see, what's another question here? Will PvP dimensions be as customizable as regular dimensions? She says yes, it'll be basically the same, except for you'll just have more tools. You can use it as guild dimension or personal dimensions. It's just adding more stuff to it. All right, let's see, what else do we got here? Are you seeing any good ones here? Yeah. Yeah, Kiwi's basically pointing at Daglar and saying that she's got backup. Ask him some questions if you like, and we'll definitely repeat them on the stream. Oh, yes. Okay, one of the issues that's kind of plaguing this small event is the inability for teams to mesh Guardians with Defiance. Is there going to be a fix in the future to allow people of different factions to team up together? All right, she's saying it's basically up to Daglar. He needs to answer that question. Yeah, she's saying that, this is just the first week of the PvP dimensions. It's way too early to, worry too much about everything. Daglar is saying, Grim, is that specifically with folks from Seastone? No, I'm hearing that it's from everybody. That was one of the requirements that they asked on the forums, is that everybody be on the same faction, because that's causing them issues. I'm not too sure the extent of it, but that's what they're saying. All right, Daglar said he will look into it. So that's good news, guys. She's saying it won't be left unintended. It will definitely be looked into. Ask some questions, guys. Let's get some answers from the developers while they're here. Well, well, Daglar is in here, so. She's asking me what I do specifically, whether I PvP or do dimensions. And my answer to that was that I'm a very heavy addict into PvP. I really don't get too creative with stuff, but I'm all about fighting other players, and I have four characters that are all in Myrmidon level areas, and this one is working on his legendary Myrmidon gear. So yeah, I PvP a lot. Yeah. And I make daily YouTube videos illustrating the builds and all that stuff. So, yeah, I like to share the knowledge with everybody. Yeah, I have Twitter and Facebook and all that good stuff. Let's go ahead and put the YouTube channel, that way people can see that. Yeah, she's basically saying that she wants there to be as much support for this as possible because it will keep being expanded upon if the players support it, basically. It's all about you guys getting into it and being creative and trying to make the most of it, and they will support you with it. All right, any other questions here yet? One of the questions here is, are there any plans for some type of arena PvP? I don't know if that falls into the PvP dimensions, but yeah, that's a Daglar question there, definitely. Yeah, she thinks it's really cool that this guild put so much effort into this dimension. They got third in the contest that they were in. And since then, they've improved upon it, such as putting a waterfall in and other stuff. It's really cool, all the effort that they're putting into promoting this dimension here. Daglar says, zero plans for arena in Rift with any form of progression built into it. Yeah. Yeah, she's saying that there's nothing holding you guys back from doing arena-style stuff in this PvP dimensions. It's basically all up to you guys to make it happen because the tools are being provided for you. It's just up to you guys to be creative and provide your own formats like they're doing tonight in this event. Yeah, she's basically saying just come to her website and check it out because there's going to be a lot of tools on there for everybody to use, such as being able to provide rankings, I believe, is what you were saying. She's saying it's up to you guys. It's if you guys support it, she'll add it to the website and see if they can't support it more and more every time. The time that this event is supposed to start, I believe, is in 15 minutes. So, Kiwi says she's going to go grab a beer and then watch the event. So, we're going to be losing her for the moment while she enjoys the event with the rest of you guys. And we're going to try to get into a better vantage point here to hopefully... Oh boy, that's some names there. Okay, could you repeat them one at a time? Okay. Yeah, she wants to really thank Godlike Awesomeness for everything that they're doing here and the promotion that they're trying to do with the PvP dimension here. It obviously means a lot. Yeah, cheers to you. Alright, they've kind of moved me here. I was over on one side at one point whenever I was testing this out, so now I'm stuck in the middle, and this is going to be kind of different. Yes. Well, the thing is I don't know where the drop-off is. I don't want to drop off it. There isn't? Oh, dropped off. Oh, is she trolling me? Told me to keep running on the glass ceiling that it wouldn't drop off. Yeah, that was something that I was worried about. I was testing how far I could walk out on the glass roof there before the drop-off hit, and now they've moved it on me, so I don't know where the drop-off is. I see that they're PvPing down there. Are they? Surely the event hasn't started already, has it? Sounds really good to me. Alright, as long as I... Uh-oh. My... Oh, okay. Oh no, our testing is a little bit different now, because now I won't be able to target people up here. No. Is the event already started? Are we missing some of it, or what's going on here? Yeah. The stream is lagging? Oh, let me see here. Yes, it is lagging a little bit. Let's adjust that some. All right, hopefully that's better. So they're just practicing right now. We're not missing anything yet, so all is good. And guys, if the stream lags at any time, let me know. I've adjusted the settings down to where it's showing no drop frames now, so let me know if it gets worse and I will adjust accordingly. So in about 10 more minutes, the event should be starting. She's moving the viewpoint back to where we originally were, which is over on the side, to where we can look down and click people as needed. I was just a little bit surprised that she moved in the middle and kind of caught me off guard there. Hopefully nobody jumps me once I get in the middle there. Once I have to move locations, it might get everybody down there hitting me. So, might have to defend myself. Yes, next time we will make sure that we run tests on the Ventrilo, that way we're not having any kind of sound issues. I highly apologize for that, guys. Well, who are you guys rooting for? I'm kind of curious who all everybody is thinking is going to win this event. Let's see here. Who all is the teams that we got? We've got Carried by Winx, Izuian, and Friends. Well, pronouncing all these names is a little difficult, that's for sure. Avalis and Friends versus Viral and Friends. We got the Commonwealth versus RG and Friends. Aborticus and Friends versus Torrid and Friends. Alright. A lot of recognizable names there. I've seen many of them on the battlefield already, so it should be pretty interesting seeing these guys in action, to say the least. Hey, how's it going, Rough Raptors? Daglar saying, go Aborticus. So, hey, no problem, Raptors. Yeah, it was kind of a last minute thing, but I think we're pulling it together all right. Are you doing okay yourself? And Kalia, could I get the lineups of the people that are going to be? Oh. Alright, I'm going to try to get the names of all the players that are going to be on each individual team, so people will be able to recognize who all's out there more. It might be a little bit hard to click around on the players as we're watching this event, so I don't want anybody to miss a friend out there that may be battling for their title. Yeah, I can introduce the teams as they're coming up, but it'd be pretty nice to have each individual player too. We'll see. All right, we're getting a list now. So let's try to write these people down. The interesting thing is I wasn't too sure if many people were going to run Warrior in this 3v3 competition, but it seems like Warrior's in several of the teams, which is pretty cool. Everybody was kind of speculating if it would be a lot of DOMs in this, if it would be a lot of just DPS rogues, or what was going to be going on. So I'm kind of curious what everybody's going to be running all together. But they did outlaw three healers going on a team all together, because that would stretch out the matches way too long. Hopefully, as people filter into this place, it's not going to lag the stream too much. If it does lag some guys, I apologize. Nerf Warriors. The thing is Warriors are so good, but in this kind of format, it's highly debatable. It's one of those things that they can go out there and damage a lot of people and survive pretty decently, but in small scale PvP such as 1v1s and stuff, they are pretty much known to suffer in those situations. Just my honest opinion, of course. Which I play a warrior myself, so I'm front and center on out there demolishing the low HP people in Warfront. So I know whenever they're pretty strong and pretty weak. Time and time again of playing this in Warfront. Got people flexing in front of me. What are you guys' opinions on what's going to be played in this tournament? Do you think it's going to be rogues and DOMs, or do you think it's going to be, take for instance, a lot of warriors? I mean, I've seen a couple of warriors already, but I haven't got the complete list of all the teams. So I know there's a couple of warriors, but I'm kind of wondering how many will be in it. Which I'm sure most teams are going to be running a cleric to heal, because cleric heals are very, very strong. And, the DPS is what I'm kind of curious about. Will they all go rogue, or are you going to see some pyros and stuff? Paragon Warrior will be good for this. Yeah. It'll be a lot of DPS, that's for sure. Number one team, Druid Cavalist. Warden. Yes, as for gear allowed in the tournament, it is pretty much anything goes. You can use whatever gear you want. I do not believe anything was restricted. Except for one item, which, what was the item that was said? It was... I'd have to find the post. But yeah, there was only one item restricted. So pretty much everything else goes. Alright, let's see what we got here. Alright, where is our drop-off point here? Oh, okay. So, right at the edge of the stairs seems to be the drop-off point for me. Hopefully nobody tries to PvP me because I'm going to be... Whoa, okay. I guess she's still working on it. But I'm going to be up there basically spectating and trying to commentate for you guys. And then all of a sudden it's going to be somebody pulling me down probably or something. It'll probably happen. Bounce Master. Yeah, it's pretty much starting time, guys. So they're going to try to organize the teams and get everybody together so that we can get the first match underway. Unfortunately, she's having to build the glass ceiling while also working on getting the teams together. Let's see if it works now. Still falling through. As usual with all events, it's trial and error and everything seems to go wrong once it's showtime. The thing is that we're basically putting an edge to the glass ceiling. That way that I can click down on people to see exactly what's going on. Because it'll be real hard to commentate whenever you basically don't know what's going on down there besides just watching people running around hitting each other. You know, seeing the skills go off and stuff like that would be really good. Let's see if we can go up now. Alright, success. Now just not to walk off. I think we might be good here. So this is going to be our vantage point. We're basically going to be looking down on the tournament like this, and hopefully we get a good view of everything. Rough Raptors, you know that you get this many people in a stream every night you live stream. Don't have to fool with us, man. Scroll all the way in. Might be kind of a, well, it might work. We'll try it out, see how you guys. You used to get around 70-ish, huh? Whenever I was live streaming all the time, I got around 20 pretty consistently, but never up in the 70-ish area, that's for sure. Enable nameplates. Let's do that. All right. So they're saying that they're going to go to the second group. So it looks like it's going to be Avalis and Friends versus Viral and Friends. So they're going to go to the second matchup because some of the people from the first matchup haven't showed up yet. Hopefully they do show up. That way we can have a complete tournament going here. Let's go ahead and set up nameplates here. Always. Will that do the job? Not looking like it's doing the job. Where am I going wrong here? Let's go with always, apply, always. There we go. All right, we're in action now. So it looks like we got Cupcakey, Viral, and having trouble clicking on him, and it's hard to see from this distance. And on the other team, we got Ganked, McKenzie, and I suppose it's going to be Liondale. Okay. Interesting, interesting. We got Warrior there. And of course, Cupcakey is probably going to be running Sentinel Cleric, while Viral is going to be probably running Marksman Rogue. So this should be interesting whenever it goes down. I'm kind of curious how this matchup's going to unfold, especially with the Warrior being included. I really didn't think people were going to throw Warriors into this, but it seems like there's going to be several Warriors, which this might shine some light on people. All right, we got on Avalis and Friends and versus Viral and Friends, which on Avalis' team is, of course, Avalis, which is a rogue, McKenzie, which is a cleric, we've got Liondale, which is Warrior, and then on Viral's team, we've got Viral, which is a rogue, Cupcakey, which is cleric, and Naked Stone is Warrior. Okay, so we've got a Warrior on each team. We've got a cleric on each team and a rogue on each team. Okay, so that seems like the go-to format for these guys right now. And we'll just wait for them to get started. And of course, fighting has already erupted. That is to be expected right there. The crowd can click on banners, and of course they're going to be fighting each other once the opportunity presents itself. Alright, apparently they're having trouble getting the team going over here, which would be Avalis' team. They are not all together yet. Not sure what's holding them up, but the interesting thing is these are people from different servers, so they're not just all in the same guild or something like that that's making them team up together. They're basically pulling together anybody that would be good for their team, regardless of guild or server, which is pretty cool. It's showing that this is already bringing players together. Yes, this is inside a PvP dimension. This is a dimension owned by Godlike Osmus, and they won third place in a PvP or dimension contest. Oh, and now it's snowing. Yeah, no mages. So far, mages are still not included on these teams, which I'm kind of curious. People are really thinking that it was going to be a lot of DOMs, so for there not to be a DOM on either team is pretty surprising. It's not what people were expecting. So we have a team that has opposite faction people, is what you're saying? Well, that wouldn't be good if they created a team with opposite faction people. Avalis said, "Sorry, we're being slow, preparing our excuses if we lose." So, a lot of high tier considered players didn't even hear about this tournament. Well, the thing is they will likely hear about it now, and whenever the next tournament happens, they may be a little more responsive. That's what it's all about. You got to start a little bit small and work your way up. And for it to be on the scale that it is right now with this PvP dimension is pretty cool to me. Alright, so the one person that was on the opposite faction on accident is being handed a faction change scroll so that she can get on, he or she can be on the right faction. Alright, looks like they're dropping a feast over there and getting ready for the match. Guess we're waiting on the to go sign. Which I'm wondering what the other rogue is going to be running. Is he going to be running Assassin Nightblade or something like that for absolute maximum DPS? Or is he going to go with... Viral is probably running a Marksman spec. Oh, the match is starting right now. So, yeah, here we go, guys. Alright, Naked Stone, which is the warrior, is leading the way along with Lindell, which he is a warrior as well. Alright, they're mixing it up really fast here. The clerics are being pulled in, and... Alright, the warrior seems to be focusing on Cupcakey, Lindell is, and Naked Stone. Which Cupcakey is pulled away now, and McKenzie is definitely getting a lot of DPS put on him. Alright, Viral is trying to do a little bit of kiting, it seems, but Lindell seems to be taking a lot of damage. And down he goes. So the warrior is went down first. Oh, Battle Rez is up. He's back in the action. Let's see if they're going to focus him to bring him down. Yep. Since he didn't have buffs up, it was going to be short work to get rid of him again. So, Avalis' team is down a member now, and it seems like they're focusing him. Yeah, he's going down now, and it's the cleanup crew, and there you go. Viral's team wins the first match. I guess the key to that match was to go after the warrior, because the warrior was obviously pumping out a lot of DPS, and if you focus the healer a little bit to CC and such, the warrior was obviously the target to go down first. So they're going to do a 2-minute cooldown break so that we can go into the next round. Naked is running Paragon Warlord. So that's a lot of DPS right there. Yes, Daglar is here. No trolling, please. The man is just here to watch some good PvP. I appreciate it, Rough Raptors. This was kind of a last-minute thing for me, and I've watched a lot of commentators, so I'm hoping I'm doing a decent job for you guys. Time to change spec. See, I was kind of curious whether people were going to go with their typical 1v1 specs, because it was a smaller scale PvP than Warfronts and Conquests and all that. I thought there would be a lot of Shaman. If people did run Warrior, I thought that they would be the Paladin mix so that they can pop a full heal if things go wrong. But also stacking DPS onto one person or the next is a legit strategy that a lot of people use in this type of format as well. So, you know, if you get 3 DPS or 2 DPS, minus the healer of course, going against one person, a lot of times that person isn't going to survive unless the healer is quick with the heals. No problem, Kalia. Yeah, Kiwi, you've already done some trolling. So I guess trolling isn't completely banned. Not many good PvP mages left in Rift. Oh no, I see some decent ones. I'm not too sure how good the mages are these days, but there's some of them that do a lot of DPS and that drain a lot of mana and stuff from me, so I always worry about mages anytime I see them. They're always vicious in their own right. Alright, it seems like both teams are up and ready. I don't see Cupcakey over there yet, I don't guess. All right, the go signal has, yeah, there's Cupcakey there. So Viral seems to have went with Stealth Spec. All right. So the Warrior is charging right in and going into it. And of course, both the Warriors are taking some damage right off the bat. All right, Viral is out of stealth. Oh, he's taking a lot of damage. And McKenzie's taking a lot of damage too. It's obvious they're trying to focus on the healer in this one. But both Warriors are sitting at around 50% life this entire match for the most part. So they're going to have to worry the entire time. You always wonder if you're going to go too deep in and if you should be kiting around the pillar there. McKenzie is down. Which Viral is at half-life? Oh, he's gotten healed back up. All right, Lindell is down. And it's looking like Avalis is about to go down, possibly. Yes, he's trying to kite to survive, and there he goes. So that's another round for Viral and friends. That was some pretty good healing by Cupcakey, because I thought Viral was about to die there. Since he went with the stealth spec, he definitely wasn't going to be as mobile as he was with the marksman spec. So, kind of looked like he was about to go down there, but the clutch heal at the end saved him, and they were able to pull it off in the end. Another 2 minute cooldown break to make sure everybody has all their cooldowns ready to go for another awesome match. Lots of burst coming up. Hikios, number one shaman North America? Question? Possibly, I'm not sure. If he's that good, I definitely want him to teach me so I can make a video on how to play a shaman. How many teams are doing this? I believe we have 8 teams. Which 8 teams were locked in. There was always possibilities of other ones, but it was 8 teams that were absolutely committed to coming. So, yes, I believe anybody is allowed into this dimension. Of course, they're wanting you to watch on live stream as much as possible rather than be in the dimension, because it will provide lag. I love how there's always a lot of speculation on who is better than who and who was great in their time and all that. It's pretty cool hearing about all that. Because a lot of it is video evidence. You can watch the guys and have your own opinions about everybody, which is pretty cool. Are we up to 58 people? It's kind of bugged out on me. It's just showing one viewer, so. Show off people's gear. You guys wanting to see what their gear looks like? From my vantage point here, it's not allowing me to click on people, so it might be a little bit difficult. Yeah, I'm sure there are going to be point of views from other people, such as Hikos there is probably going to live stream the event as well from his point of view. So if you guys want to see how his point of view is while he's in the match, Be sure to check out the other live streams too. All right, seems we're underway again. So, all right, a little bit of pressure being put on Viral there. Naked Stone seems to be putting the pressure on McKenzie. McKenzie seeming to be focused a lot now. Probably the entire other team is putting all the DPS on McKenzie and trying to get him down. Oh, that's a fight for his life. It didn't work out. Was having him on the ropes the entire time, and he was doing everything he could to survive. I guess all the CCs were down and couldn't peel off of them. And they're just cleaning up now. So it's 3-0 for Viral's team. And I'm pretty sure that's the win, since it's the best out of five. Control U. Yeah, we better do that. Sorry about that. We should have had the UI down the entire time. Which we might have to put the UI back up in a moment to see what the next matchup is going to be, because we're kind of going out of order. But as the match goes on, I will definitely be hiding the UI from now on. My apologies, guys. So let's put it up for one moment so that we can see what the next teams are going to be. So it'll be the second game, but scheduled to be the third game, will be Commonwealth on Nightfall side against RG and Friends. So we got RG, Ganked, and who is the third person over there? Chef Boer or D's? So that's going to be the three people over there. Let's see. With the Commonwealth, I'm not too sure who all is going to be on that team just yet. We'll see as they step up. My fellow troll, RG. Yeah. The dimension name is Godlike Arena, which is made by Godlike Awareness. Alright, so the Commonwealth will be Hikos, which is definitely going to be running Shaman. We got Trunks, which is a mage. And Kaz, which will be running Cleric. RG and Friends will be RG, which is running a Rogue. Ganked, running a Rogue. And Chef Borodese, which is running Cleric. And the action is underway now. They have been given the okay to go and engage. So we've got a couple of Rogues here on one team. Alright, so it's obvious the stealth DPS method, and they're focusing Kaz right off the bat. Chef Borodese is taking a lot of damage. It looks like Kaz is about to go down. The clutch heals and the shield on him. So he was able to save himself, and now they're changing targets. Hikko seems to be focused on the pet. I guess he's not wanting the pet to be CC, and Chef Borodese is going down. Look how much damage he's taking. He's got Hikos and several, and the pet on him. Kaz is still being focused. RG and Ganked and crew is all trying to get the healer down. Which Chef Bordeez is still being focused by Hikos. Which the Shaman DPS is pretty insane. Ganked has been turned into a squirrel, so there is a little bit of Dom going on out there. Chef Bordeez is constantly taking damage. He's just running for his life the entire time. They're not letting up on him one bit. And Kaz, it seems like the same targets on both teams. They're not letting up on them. See, yeah. The nameplates goes down with the control U. So, looks like they're focusing on Trunks now. Ganked is the last person up on the other team. Yeah, it looks like it's about to be a wipe up. And Hikos and team pulls off the first match. Sorry about the little bit of stutter there. I was trying to adjust the UI for you guys to see if the nameplate stayed up. But unfortunately, they didn't. Yeah, Kaz was running for his life the entire time trying to survive. It was a never-ending running duel for him. Did I mix them up? Ganked is rogue, RG is rogue. Did I call it wrong? Yeah, the definite strategy by RG and Ganked and his team is focus on one person and dishing out as much rogue DPS. I'm sure they are probably, well, not sure, but they're probably running the assassin, possibly Nightblade mix for the optimal DPS. Which Hikos was focusing on Chef Bordeez as much as he could to try to hammer him down. So that seemed like the key to have the clerics running at all cost. So they're having their 2 minute cooldown rest here. I see a mixture of both. I see a lot of 61 Sins and also a lot of Sin Nightblades. It seems like both are doing really well in PvP right now. So, yeah, the Riftstalker mix is definitely nice with a little bit more tankiness, and that's also a very common spec run in PvP. So it's 1-0 for Hikos' team right now. And the Shaman DPS definitely was a big problem for the other healer. Alright, they've been given the okay to go now. And they are engaging Kaz right off the bat. And the same strategy for Hikos. He's chasing Chef Bordeez right now and trying to pressure the healer at all cost. Yeah, the definite strategy is to focus the healers. And, two squirrels there. Ganked and RG were both squirreled. But as you can see, it's all about focusing the healers for both of these teams. They're thinking that the pressure on the healer is going to cause the rest of the team to go down. Chef Bordeez is about to die now. Can he pull up? No, the clutch heal wasn't happening. So Chef Bordeez has died now, and they're still focusing on Kaz, trying to get him down. But Ganked is at half-life, and Kaz seems to be pulling it off. And it looks like it's just, no, Kaz has went down. So you've got a 2v2 match on our hands, guys. With no healers on board. Alright, so RG is being pressured and ganked has already went down, I believe. Or did he slip away? No, he slipped away and he just engaged and got finished off. So another round for Hikos. It was kind of hard to see what was going on whenever you had people slipping away. Yeah, the Shaman Deeps is definitely the big thing in this match. With him being able to pressure the healer so much, it's becoming just one of those things where he's running for his life and not able to heal his team as much as he would like to. Very valid strategy, and Hikos has seemed to be focused on one thing, and that is a healer. Nerf Hikos' outfit. Which I'm sure with RG and Gank's DPS output both playing rogue the way that they are, I can see that their strategy was they were thinking that they could burst down one person or the next as fast as possible, and then possibly move on to a 3-on-2. That is what I assume their strategy is. However, it seems to not be working out with Hikos pressuring their healer the entire time. Which they seem to be doing the same to the other team, but the healer isn't going down as much as they would like to. So they're going through their 2-minute cooldown right now, letting all cooldowns go back up, and so that the heals and DPS could be at optimal ranges. This is definitely a duel between clerics, it seems. Who can stay alive and heal their team? Because the rest of the DPS is pretty much only focused on the healers. Oh boy. And the match has started. I almost missed it there. They are underway and whoa, lots of damage already going out. And everybody's sitting at half life already. Chef Ortiz is being pressured by Hikos again. We've got Kaz being pressured by RG again. And Ganked is squirreled at the moment. Chef Ortiz is at a quarter of life. The Shaman Deeps is on him hard, and he has popped ugly. He is pretty much immune to any kind of damage coming up for a short period of time. Ganked is still focusing on Kaz, but he has been squirreled. Now the pressure is back on Shep Ortiz, and he is obviously trying to line of sight and juke around Hikos as much as he can. And as you can see, both teams, it's all about these clerics. And Chef Ortiz goes down. The clerics were the ones taking the most damage and definitely being focused. Kaz is near death right now. So it could be an even team again. No, they've pulled off the heels. Ganked is at a quarter of life or less now. Kaz seems to be surviving but trying to kite. And Hikos is taking down another target. Is RG dead now? So, yeah. There you go, guys. A clean sweep by Hikos and team. 3-0. Very good game. Very good game. And we seem to be getting a little bit of support by people here. Let's see here. We've got Kiwi says that she'll give away a hellbug if we get the stream to 100 people. Get your friends. It's going to be a toxic hellbug. So there will be a randomization of giving away a toxic hellbug if you guys can get the stream to 100 viewers. And Dagler says he will give away a Radiant Infinity Cell if you get to 100. And by me, I mean Kiwi will orchestrate that, and I'll have Morgana do it. So that's two things. If we hit 100 viewers on this live stream, we will have a Toxic Hellbug given away and also a Radiant Infinity Cell. For those that are claiming that they have done 100 wins in Conquest and not getting a Radiant Cell, get your friends in here because you might get it this time. The next matchup is going to be Aborticus and Friends, which his team is going to be Aborticus, Nightmarish, and Friends. And the team that they're going up against is Torrid and Friends, which is Torrid, a warrior, Duddits, which is a mage, and Warrens, or Warrien. Yeah, that's how you say it, which is cleric. Some of these names are a little bit difficult to pronounce sometimes. Join in the fun, Rough Raptors. If we get the stream up to 100 viewers, let's see if we can get everybody to give away something nice. Uh-oh, Daglar is saying that he's about to spam the North American servers. This should be interesting. So we got Aborticus and team on one side and Torrid and Friends on the other side. Which, we got double rogue cleric and warrior mage cleric. Alright, this is going to swap it up a little bit. We're probably, well, I don't know, is one of them going to be marksman? Or are they both going to go stealth DPS like RG's team did? But I can pretty much say that the mage is going to be a dom. And the match is underway. We've got charging right into Friends. Which Friends is the cleric, so they're putting a lot of pressure on him as well as on Duddits. Alright, they're not wanting the mage to get much damage or drain off if that's the spec he's running. Lots of heals going on. Not too much damage being dealt out just yet. Friends is getting pressure a little bit, and Aborticus has a little bit of damage as well as Warren's. Warren. Nightmarish seems to be sticking to Warren and not letting up. Duddits is taking a lot of damage as well. Aborticus isn't letting up on him. And seems to be a little bit of pressuring by Torrid on Friends right now. Duddits is about dead, and they are not letting the dom get off. So Warren is down as well. So they're pressuring Friends now, and it seems to be just a cleanup crew, I believe. Yeah, with Duddins and Warren down, it's just a matter of cleaning up the enemy team. And Aborticus's team seems to have pulled it off, and the other team seems to have suffered a devastating defeat. Very good match there. It was obvious they didn't want the dom to get off too much. There was a lot of pressure put on Duddits, and they didn't want any kind of drains happening, that's for sure. The mana wrenching wasn't going to happen. Didn't seem to see too much squirreling there either, if anybody got squirreled. Thank you for the shout out, Daglar, and hopefully we hit 100 viewers in this channel. That way that we can give out the Toxic Hellbug and the Radiant Infinity Cell. We're going through the 2-minute rest period so everybody can get their cooldowns back up and see if there's a change in strategy. Which I thought that the Doms would be running a lot more rampant than they are in this tournament so far. I think that's the second Dom that we've seen so far out of, what is it, 6 teams now? So, and the match is underway. They have been given the okay to charge in, and Torrid is going straight after Friends. And we got a lot of pressure from Aborticus onto the Dom once again. Duddits is being pressured. And Franz is being pressured. Warrens is taking some damage from Nightmarish. So the damage is definitely being spread out between everybody. There is a lot of pressure being done on Franz now. But Duddits isn't receiving as much pressure as he was earlier. Now he's getting the pressure. He's definitely taking a lot of damage now, but Franz is taking so much damage he's about to go down. And the heals did not come through. Franz is down. So they're really chain hitting Warren for the moment. And I imagine he'll probably go down unless he can survive the pressure. Nope. And down he goes, and they're going to... They're going after Duddits. Nightmarish is down. Nightmarish is down. Aborticus and Torrid. Is this the one-on-one match? And I think there's just too much damage on Aborticus. Oh, we can't see the life. Alright, Torrid pulled it off. We had a 1v1 match there for a short bit, but Aborticus just had way too much damage on him to survive that. So, very nice match there. So it's a 1-1. We've got a match on our hands. This is not going to be a sweep like the other ones have been. So we've got 120 viewers in the channel right now. That means that a Toxic Hellbug is going to be given away, as well as a Radiant Infinity Cell. So we're at 120 viewers right now. That means that the prizes are going to be given out, guys. I've never given did a giveaway on my stream, so I might have to be walked through it. Thank you so much, Daglar, for the support, and I imagine Godlike Awesomeness really appreciates it as well. The PvPing that we're getting to see here is pretty awesome, and with you guys' support, couldn't ask for more. And we're up to 135 viewers. So, yeah, it's really cool that Daglar and the developers and, of course, Kiwi are willing to give away stuff the way that they are. There's not many other things that... Oh, Kiwi's giving me a call here. How's it going, Kiwi? Can you hear me, Kiwi? Yes, I can hear you. How's it going? Yeah? Never done a giveaway, so we're going to have you walk me through it if you don't mind. I'm assuming possibly not. So, I mean, I've got Chrome here, so just need to figure out where we need to go after that. And we've got, okay, and we've got the match underway as well, so. All right. Torrid is going ahead and charging in at Franz. And where is the damage being done besides Franz? It seems like the, okay, Warren is taking a lot of damage now. He's at half health, as well as Franz being pressured by Torrid. And the healing is really good on these teams. They are not doing too much. Well, Franz is taking a lot of damage. Oh, man, the burst damage. Look at the burst happening on Franz. And he goes down. Oh, my gosh, that was a lot of damage. He went from half health to almost dead, and it was a matter of finishing him off. And Aborticus is near death himself. Is he going to stay in the pocket? Yes, he does, until he dies. Wow. I thought he would try to kite, but he decided to go ahead and try to get in his last hits, or he was CC'd, one or the other. Nightmarish is pressuring Warren now. And Nightmarish is at 50% health because of Torrid. Torrid is not letting up on him right now. Well, there goes Nightmarish. And that wraps up that match. Good match by Torrid and friends. And it is now one win against two wins. All right. So where is this link that you were sending me? All right. We're going to try to do this giveaway for you guys, so somebody will win a Toxic Hellbug, and also a Radiant Infinity Cell is going to be given away. Is that Rough Raptors is doing it? Ah, so Rough Raptors is also offering a $5 credits in Rift. So yeah, we're getting even more giveaways going just shortly. Uh-oh, if we hit 150, Daglar says he'll toss in something else. No idea what, though. And we're sitting at 142 viewers at the moment. And, of course, a little self-promotion for myself while we're here. Oh, we've dropped two viewers. We're at 140 now. We've got to get 10 more to get another giveaway by Daglar. All right, sounds good. Yes, many, many thanks to Daglar, Kiwi, and Rough Raptor so far for offering things to give away. And Daglar says 150 pet. Oh boy. So, yeah, we've got to hit 150, guys, so we can get the Pithos special. Yeah, three times battles the pet. Oh, the match is underway, guys. I almost missed it once again. Oh, Warren's is taking a lot of damage, already at half life. And Friends is being pressured by Torhid, but it seems that his heals are doing pretty good. So, oh, Torhid's at half life. So the damage is being mixed up once again, but Warren is definitely taking the most of it. And he's back at full health, but Friends is still taking a lot of damage from Torhid. And, oh, he's at full health. So he was able to pull off the heals and clutch it up. Duddits seems to be unaffected by everybody. He's getting to free cast, and I imagine he's draining lots of people. Warren is about dead. He is all, and he goes down. So Duditz is still free casting. Now Bordicus is on him, so he's taking a lot of damage now. He's at a quarter life, and he is dead now. So now they're hitting Franz. Torrid is about at a quarter to a half life, now down to a quarter, and he goes down. So we've got a real match on our hands, guys. 2 wins to 2 wins. This is an awesome match right here. And we have officially hit 150 viewers. Keretic at Deepwood says, best streamer ever. Thank you, man. Two-minute cooldown break, guys. So we're going to have a momentary break while we try to figure out how to do these giveaways. Lots and lots of stuff are being added. Did you send in Skype? Okay, yeah. All right, it says added to Chrome, so. How exactly does this work now? One second, guys. Sorry if there's a lack of commentary, and we are up to 162 viewers now. So I'm just trying to find this little button that you're saying. It's in the add-ons, I imagine. I just said it was added to Chrome, and I don't see anything else just yet. The match is underway, and Tord is charging right into Franz. All right, we seem to have a lot of pressure on Duditz this time. They're not letting him free cast like they did last match. And Duditz is being pressured heavily, as well as Warren. Franz is still being chased by Tord, basically using the same strategy that was used in the last match. Franz is seeming to have to heal himself a lot here. Duditz is being pressured as well as Warren. It seems like the same targets are being targeted every time here. Warren is being pressured a lot by Nightmarish, whereas Torrid is CCing and trying to DPS Franz down as much as he can. Duditz is being not focused. He is able to free cast now. And he's obviously pressuring Franz. Oh, now he's changing targets here. Warren is taking a lot of damage. And the added pressure by Duditz was definitely the nail in the coffin there. Franz seems to be taking a lot of damage from Torrid, but not too bad. Now they're focusing on Duditz, but is it too late? But Duditz goes down, so maybe they can clean house now. Franz is still getting a lot of pressure, but he's able to heal himself up, and Torrid seems to be going down now. And there goes Torrid. So Bordicus and team pull it off, 3 wins to 2. very good match that time. It wasn't a sweep, it was down to the wire, and the rubber match was the deciding factor. All right, now where are we at again here? Okay, it's added to Chrome. All right. Where is it supposed to be at on the screen? All right. Where is it supposed to be at on the screen? A gift box. All right. I'm not seeing a gift box. Boy, so many issues here. Wish everything worked out perfectly. Where is it supposed to be at on the screen? Let's try to hide some of the other add-ons, and maybe that will make them reveal. I'm not seeing a gift box. Boy, so many issues here. Wish everything worked out perfectly. Where is it supposed to be at on the screen?
Let's try to hide some of the other
add-ons,
and maybe that
makes more sense.
Make them reveal.
That will definitely be a good place to be. Where is it supposed to be at on the screen?
Let's try to hide some of the other add-ons, and maybe
that
makes more sense.
Make them reveal.
Oh yeah. Sorry guys, didn't mean to have any feedback there.
Oh, match is underway here. We've got revamped in team against... Yeah, boy, this match got underway while I was trying to set that up. But let's see here. We got Mr. Sturdy. Okay, this is Wicks and Friends against Iswin and Friends. Which we've got a warrior on Iswin's team as well, which is pretty cool. We got Fry Dangerous, which is a mage. So I imagine we're going to see some more Dom action here. Oh, and they killed me up here. Look at that. All right. We figured that would happen. All right, so Revamp seems to be kiting around, and CSX, which is the healer on that team, is being pressured quite a bit. Now Revamp is getting hit by Iswin, but Lix is definitely the one pressuring CSX. Lix was squirreled and definitely being controlled, but now Iswin seems to be on Mr. Studley, which he's now squirreled. So yeah, Fry Dangerous is free casting. Look, they're not focusing on the Dom right now. They're allowing him to tee off with his mana drains and energy drains all he wants right now. CSX is trying to get some mana back, it looked like. Mr. Studley is pressuring Revamped a little bit, but not too much, it doesn't seem. Iswin is trying to do some DPS to Revamped while CSX is taking a lot of damage by Lix. And will he go down? Yes, he will. Lix is down now. So that's one person down. Now they're focusing on Iswin. Lix is putting a lot of DPS on Iswin, and it looks like he's about to go down. Yep. He wasn't able to line of sight as much as he would like to, and now they're just finishing up by hitting Fry Dangerous. Okay. I guess now I'll soul walk. Okay, I need to make you a mod, you say? Oh, no, that's... Yeah, I've just never really done too much like this, so is it /mod? And... Yeah, I'm usually just live streaming and not doing anything else, so... what was your Twitch name on here? All right, there you go. Added as a moderator. So, hopefully nobody kills me this time. Yeah, they the comments in Twitch right now is that Fry Dangerous looks like he DC'd, so... That's rather unfortunate. Yeah. Thanks a lot, Daglar. Definitely a learning experience. So we're getting ready for the next round here. Revamped and Friends against, or it's Wix and Friends against Izuin and Friends. So. Well, at the top of my live stream, it said that the extension was active, but I'm not seeing the button anywhere. All right, the match is underway here. Looks like Fry Dangerous is using split personality and free casting at will. Lix is pressuring CSX and... Mr. Studley is being pressured by Izwin. So, yeah, Fry Dangerous still isn't having any DPS done on him and free casting on who he chooses. Revamped is going after Mr. Studley now. And it seems like Lix is trying to pressure CSX now. CSX is having a lot of damage done to him. The clutch healing is definitely going to pay off if he's going to... Well, it doesn't look like he's... Well, yeah, he is surviving. I thought he was going to continue to be pressured and possibly go down there, but... Lix has just been squirreled, so the pressure on CSX is a little bit less, but it's adding up again, and he's one hit from dead, and he is dead. CSX has went down, and now the pressure is on Revamped, it looks like. He's trying to line aside a bit, but... Yeah, Izwin is not letting up on him, and Fry Dangerous is taking a lot of damage by Lix. And Fry Dangerous is down. Mr. Sudley is at 3/4 life, but he doesn't seem to be in too much trouble as... Mr. Studley seems to be healing up, revamped. Izwin is taking a lot of damage now. Is he about to go down? Yes, Izwin is down. So, revamped in team. Another win in the books. Yeah, Revamp's team, or Wix's team, is a rogue, which is Lix. We got Revamped, which is a cleric, and Mr. Studley, that is a cleric. So double cleric and rogue. And the other team, of course, is warrior, mage, and cleric. As you can see, definitely running a Dom spec that a lot of people thought was going to be included on these tournaments a lot. So... Yeah, I can hear you. If you're wondering why there's a pause in the commentary, I'm trying to get another giveaway program set up here. Alright, Mr. Studley is already getting the damage being put on him. And CRX is being pressured by Lix, whereas Mr. Studley is about to go down. He's already at half health. CSX is still being pressured by Lix, but Lix has been CC'd. Revamped has a little bit of damage, but Mr. Studley healed him back up to full. CSX seems to have a little bit of damage put on him, but it's not too bad just yet. Lix is trying to pressure him, but he's able to heal himself up pretty well. Izwin is trying to focus on Mr. Studley, it appears. CSX is once again being pressured a lot by Lix. And Izwin. Is Izwin putting Mr. Studley at 75% health? It seems like the heals are doing really well on this team, these two teams. It's all a matter of keeping the healers alive so that they can heal everybody else. Revamped down to half health now. He's trying to line of sight and try to get Izwin off of him a little bit. CSX is still being pressured by Lix. Lix is not letting up on him. Mr. Studley throwing a shield up on Revamped. And CSX once again going down to half life because of Lix. Izwin at 75% health or so. He seems to be really convinced that Fry Dangerous is a problem. CSX is still being pressured by Lix. Uh-oh, down to less than 50% health and the big heal landed, but he is back down. He is nearly dead. Can Lix finish him off? He's at about 10% health now. But the CC right on time. Lix was CC'd and not able to finish him off. But the pressure is still on CSX. Mr. Studley is now at 50% health, but healed up pretty well. It seems like the damage done to Mr. Studley isn't putting him in too bad of a situation. He seems to be healing up at will. Fry Dangerous about to go down, and he does. Fry Dangerous is now on the ground dead. Lix is now having a little bit of a one-on-one with Izwin there. With Mr. Studley, of course, healing Lix, so it's a little bit. And Revamped, of course, thinks that the match is pretty much in hand and is mounted up, running around all he likes. Izwin is now down. So, Wicks and Friends pulls off another win. 3-0 sweep. Alright, try to get this giveaway program here working. Sorry about the slow giveaways, guys. It's a learning process, to say the least. All right, Nightbot is going. So now how do we do the giveaway now that Nightbot is active? Oh, we probably click on giveaways here. So let's start a giveaway. Okay. Everybody, make sure that you say something in the chat so I make sure that you're part of this giveaway. What should we give away first? Should it be the Toxic Hillbug? Toxic Hillbug first. And sorry guys, it took me so long. I've never done a giveaway on here before. And Kiwi basically walked me through it. But we are good to go now. So leave a comment in the chat right now so I can make sure that you're part of this giveaway. All right. So if anybody's listening, they've most likely already left a comment, as we're at 206 viewers right now. All right, let's go ahead and do this giveaway. And we have a winner. Okay, the winner is Oopsie. Yes. All right, sounds good. So Kiwi is basically saying that she'll help me out with the giveaway here, if you're wondering who I'm responding to. Yeah, UBC is just... Yeah, he even said how to pronounce his name. All right, the next giveaway that we're going to do is the $5 credit package from Rough Raptors. And be sure to leave a comment in the chat there so that we can do the giveaway and make sure that you're all included on it. And for extra bonus points, always follow the stream. You know. Not that... Yep, you must be following the stream in order to win this next prize. That is the stipulation Kiwi has put before us. So, all right, guys, make sure that you're following, and I can see here if you're following or not, so make sure that you're following. All right, are we ready for the next one? Thank you, UBC. All right. What do you think, Kiwi? Ready to go? All right. We got BMN30 currently follows this channel. Yes. Thank you to Rough Raptors for this giveaway. Make sure that you show him lots of love and be sure to visit his Twitch channel when he is live streaming. The guy puts on a lot of really good raid content and very fun to watch. What? Oh, yeah. Kiwi's basically saying that I'm not showing her enough love. She gave away the toxic hell bug, and guys, support the PvP Dimensions and go to her website. She's going to be showing lots of support for everybody, and you guys need to support her in order for the support to be shown everywhere. The love is all around. Okay, the Radiant Infinity Cell is next, guys. Thank you to Tryon for giving away this. And we will do the drawing in just a second. Leave a comment and make sure you're following, guys. And know that this would not be happening if Daglar had not come in here and offered it to you guys. So it's pretty awesome that they're supporting the players like this, and we're about to give away a Radiant Infinity Cell. Here we go, and the roll is happening now. Oh, somebody is not following the channel. Kiwi is saying that I've got to read the name. All right, the person that supposedly would have won but was not following was Pubnut01. Poor guy. All right, make sure you're following, guys. So we will roll once again. This is for Radiant Infinity Cell. And the winner is, currently following the channel, is Adam West is Batman, a comic book fan. Obviously a comic book fan. Yes, please, guys, show lots of love to Daglar for doing this for you guys, putting out the Radiant Infinity Cell. A lot of people are struggling to get them right now because of the RNG, and we just was able to give out one because of Daglar. Yeah, it was that package, wasn't it? What was the other thing Daglar wanted us to give away? What was it, chat? He said once we hit 150 viewers. Oh, now we've got a match going on. We've got to delay the next giveaway. All right, we've got Revamp's team, or should I say Wix's team, against Viral's team. So the Lix is putting a lot of pressure on Cupcakey, whereas Viral is putting a lot of pressure on Mr. Studley. Naked Stone and, well, Revamp seems to be casting from a distance, but Cupcakey is taking a lot of damage, but able to heal back up, and Ugly has been popped on Cupcakey, so she is fine. But Mr. Studley is on the ropes right now. He is constantly being left at half health, whereas Cupcakey is now at 1/3 health, and now down to 10%. Cupcakey is down, so the healer for Viral's team is now dead, and let's see how the rest of the match goes. Viral is pressuring Mr. Studley, hoping he can get the healer down, but it's looking Viral to clean up house. Mr. Studley is being damaged quite a bit. He's at 50% health. Revamp, cast him from a distance, and Lix. Alright, that's the match. Viral's team is now dead, and Wix's team has pulled off the win. So now it's 1-0, and wait a minute, was there interference? There was interference, wasn't there? Staked off, interfered. Alright. Yeah, we had some interference, guys. Mm-hmm. Kiwi wanted to stress that that's going to happen quite often in these dimensions if the design isn't the way that it needs to be. It's going to be up to the players to make sure that that stuff doesn't happen. Okay, guys. The bar has been raised substantially. We've got 5 more giveaways to give away. Daglar has provided 3 times the Paddles Pet, as well as 2 times 17,500 credits. Did you guys hear that? 17,500 credits times 2. So, yeah. We're going to be... Make sure that you guys are following this channel, because if you miss out on these giveaways, you are going to be facepalming. And also, everybody, I need you to do this before we do the next giveaway. Everybody that is in this dimension watching the PvP matches, please plus one it. Give these guys some love for putting on an awesome event. You guys need to show the love, because they're showing you guys a great show right now. All right, shall we do the Paddles Pet first? All right. Let's do a Paddles Pet, and the drawing is happening in just a second. Make sure you're following and leave a comment in the chat area so we make sure that you're in on this roll here. Yeah, Daglar is making it rain. Oh, Ferdinand, 1977 does not follow this channel. Burn. I think I just snorted with that laugh, but okay. Reroll, guys, reroll. Yes. Okay, reroll, guys. The Paddles Pet is going to... It's still rolling. Mr. Megaphone is currently following this channel. Congratulations, Mr. Megaphone. Make sure that you make a post on the forum saying Daglar rocks. Yeah, everybody in this chat should make that post. I mean, he is definitely showing you guys a lot of love right now. And special thanks to Kiwi for recording everybody's names as they're winning and helping me out a lot, because I'm winging this, guys. Yes, Mr. Megaphone, you do win. And the next match is underway. We got Lix pressuring Cupcakey right now, whereas Viral and Naked Stone seem to be all over Mr. Studley right now, making sure that he is going to have to fight for his life. Oh man, look at the band of squirrels. What's going on there? Mr. Studley is getting a lot of pressure done on him. It seems like the definite focus is going to be on the healers here. They're trying to put as much DPS as possible out. Mr. Studley seems to be CC'd, but he is healing up just fine. And Cupcakey has popped ugly. The transformation is underway so she can survive the damage that Lix is providing. Oh, Mr. Studley goes down and a massive amount of damage the Viral and team was putting onto him. Mr. Studley is on the ropes right now at 3/4 health and down to a quarter now, whereas Cupcakey is at 50% health. Both healers are at 50% health. Mr. Studley dipped down to a quarter health, but seems to be surviving now. Naked Stone is at 50% health with his warrior. Mr. Studley is being pressured a lot. Oh man, he almost went down there, but he's sitting at 50% life and now at a quarter. The damage is not letting up on him, and it's the same with Cupcakey. Look at the damage being put on her. And she was able to pop transformation and go into ugly form to survive it.
Oh, and who did we have go down there? Was that Interruption? Revamped is at 50% health now. Did we have another Interruption? Cupcakey is almost dead now. Naked Stone is at 25% health and seems to be struggling now. And Lix is providing lots of DPS right now. Naked Stone is about to go down. And he is dead. And Lix is at about 10% health now and goes down. Viral at about 25% health. Twisted Blister? Do we have a lot of Interruption or what's going on here? Yes, lots and lots of confusion by lots of people interrupting. So, yeah, interference, guys, interference. People are just jumping around as they feel fit. Everybody, please stay out of the arena so we can have a good time and see who the best PvPers are here. At least on this given night. Alright, so we've given away one Paddles the Pet so far. Let's go ahead and give away the second one. So, they can see who's jumping down in there. Kiwi's asking how we can trace to see who's interfering. Do you want me to repeat that? Okay. Kiwi's basically saying, Daglar, please help us out with the interference problems. Kick people out of the dimension if you can. But the score is 1-0 right now, and we've been having a lot of interference. So, all right. Let's go ahead and give away another Paddles. Alright, the roll is underway, and make sure you're following, guys. Make sure you do not miss out on this. And, oh man, you never guess who just won. Tryon Morgana does not follow this stream, guys. Does not follow this stream, guys. Morgana. That was very interesting of a draw, but unfortunately Morgana does not win Paddles the Pet. Alright, we will go to the next drawing here. Let's go and see who wins it next. That was epic, yes it was. And Morgana says she is following now. So, alright, we got Adelial, I believe that's how you say it, but he is following the stream, so we've got the second winner of Paddles the Pet. Okay guys, the rules are that whenever you win and you are following the stream, Kiwi is going to send you a message on Twitch and you will need to reply to her to let her know what your characters are in the game. So make sure that you are checking your Twitch messages and that way that you can get the prizes that were given out to you guys. So that's the second Paddles the Pet provided by Daglar and his team at Tryon. Very cool, very cool. And we have the next match underway here. Alright, Naked Stone has been CC'd right off the bat, so they're definitely not wanting the Warrior DPS hitting them too early. Mr. Studley taking a lot of damage in Cupcakey. It's again another pressuring of the healers.
Cupcakey at 75% health. It seems like the Heels are doing really well once again. These two teams seem to really have the Heels mastered because the DPS is not able to bring them down anytime soon. It's probably going to be a mana issue by the time these guys go down. Cupcakey has popped transformation, so is in invincible form for the moment. And Mr. Studley constantly going down below 50% health, but able to heal himself up repeatedly. The damage is just not affecting him enough to make him go down. Cupcakey being pressured once again by Lix. And Mr. Studley almost went down with naked stone pressuring him. Viral churning out the DPS himself, but he seems to be CC'd over there. Did Mr. Studley go down? It looks like it. Yes, he did. So, Revamp, now at 25% health, and is he going to go down? Yes, he does. Cupcakey at about 30% health and struggling to stay alive right now. Lix has just been knocked down himself. So, Viral and team pull off the win there. Very good match, guys. No interruptions that time. Don't worry if you haven't won yet. We've got three more giveaways, and the two major ones are coming up. So what do you think, Kiwi? What should we give away next? All right, guys. Kiwi recommends that we give away the credit package. Now that is 17,500 credits. In case you guys didn't know. Uh-oh, Daglar's saying I need to check my inventory. Or are you talking about my mail or my inventory? Because I've got some daily crap in my bag right now. So, all right, guys, let's give away this huge credit package by Daglar. This is awesome that he's providing this. All right, make sure that you're leaving a comment in the chat and make sure you're following the stream. If you're not following the stream, you do not win. We will go to the next person, unfortunately. Alright, it must be in my mail, Daglar. So, let's roll, guys. Big roll. Two hundred and twenty people in the stream right now, guys. Oh, the mailbox down there, I can't get it. All right, I'll get it in just a second. All right, let's roll for this. I know you guys are wanting it. 17,500 credits. And the winner is... Dewdrop does not follow this channel. Dewdrop does not follow this channel. 17,500 credits. All right, let's drop down real fast. Oh, I can't get. Oh. Oh, the mailbox here is a Guardian one, so it's making me attack it rather than open it. All right, so roll again, guys. The winner is Yurami, which is currently following the channel. He says, oh my god, that's me, lol. Yes, congratulations on 17,500 credits provided by Daglar. Make sure that you post on the forums and tell how much Daglar rocks. I can't open that mailbox. It's a Guardian one. It's making me attack it. And the next match is underway. So, let's see here. We got Mr. Studley made sure that he's shielded up. That way the pressure is not too bad on him. Oh, he's going down really fast anyway. Through the shield and through the health really fast. Cupcakey, of course, is being pressured as well. The strategy by these two teams. And, of course, we got the same guy running around. So, Revamped is at 50% health now. Cupcakey is being pressured, but seems to be faring quite well with it. Revamped at 50% health, but now full life and shielded. Seems like the Mr. Studley is in grave danger and he goes down. Wow. The damage was way too much. It was very high burst right then. Revamped is being pressured and Cupcakey is pop transformation to stay alive there. And Viral and Team. Guess that's the match. Very nice, very nice. Oh, yes, okay. Lix just popped out right then. Alright, I was wondering where he was. Apparently he has decided to slip away at that time. So, that's a 3-0 sweep there. Very nice job by Viral's team. So, should we give away another Paddles? Paddles the pet. Paddles the pet. Everybody's just dying for the role, man. They're... How bad do you guys want it? Do you guys want to give away the Paddles the Pet and then another 17,500 credits? Are you guys wanting it? Alright. Make sure that you're following the stream and let's get a roll going here. And make sure you're following, guys. Make sure you're following. Do not end in catastrophe like the 17,500 credits bypassed somebody earlier. And the roll. We are rolling for Paddles the Pet. And it is Leastrellus. And currently following the channel. Congratulations on your Paddles the Pet. Provided by Daglar. Make sure you guys show a lot of love to Daglar. The guy is just awesome for all he's doing for you guys right now. Alright guys, here's a little bit of a twist. Kiwi has recommended that we save the last credit package until the last fight. So you guys are going to have to support this PvP dimension and watch who is going to triumphant tonight. Yeah, guys, make sure that you are posting on the forums and saying how much you love Daglar. The guy is just doing awesome stuff for us tonight. All right. So it looks like we got Hikthos and friends on one side, and not sure who the other matchup is going to be just yet. Oh, there's a mailbox down there. If only I could reach it. How long? My eyes are getting heavy. I'm not too sure, man. Your eyes shouldn't be getting heavy with the excitement that's going on in these matches. Oh, he's got
Okay, I've got to see it. All right, so I need to jump down there and try to check that mailbox. Okay, so we are going to jump down there and see if we can get that mailbox. Or go down. Am I trapped? Nope. Oh, it's a Guardian mailbox. I can't open it. Gosh darn it. I'm a Defiant. I cannot open that mailbox. No, I don't. Somebody get me a Defiant mailbox so I can check it. Daglar wants me to check my mail, and I need to. Oh, it's... I can't check it. And of course I'm getting attacked as soon as I jump down. Defiant mailbox down. Okay. Let's check this out. What did he provide to me? What? It's showing them all as a dagger. Yeah, I'm in PvP. It won't let me check my mailbox. No! Daglar wants me to check my mailbox and I can't do it since I'm flagged PvP right now. Okay, I'm going to leave the dimension and invite me back, Kalia. Or, wait a minute, I'll just check the mailbox while I'm in Tempest Bay real fast. Uh-oh. What is this? A black dire riding squirrel. Daglar, you rock. I'm going to make a post on the forum saying you rock. Oh my gosh. Alright, black dire riding squirrel. And what's the other thing here? We've got... Grants me the title, the exemplar... extraordinary, should I say that right? Thank you very much, Daglar. You rock, man. Yes. Oh my gosh. Thank you so much, Daglar. And guys, make sure you're showing him a lot of love as well. Alright, I don't know if I'll be able to get back up. I think she took down the Dom banner, so we might not be able to get back up. But thank you guys for everybody that's tuning in. You guys are making this event a big success, and this is what it's all about. It's all about the community coming together and supporting stuff like this and putting on stuff like this for godlike awareness, awesomeness to put on what they're doing. Is really, really cool. We might have lost our great vantage point, sadly to say. Yes, make sure that you guys are following, because this is going to get pretty awesome just shortly whenever we give away the 17,500 credits provided by Daglar. I I'm not sure. How many fights do we have left over now? And Daglar says, also, for the love of God, do not PM him and ask for stuff or offer him nudes for loot. It does not work. All right, I'm up and at my great vantage point once again. Thank you for getting me back up here so I can broadcast from a great angle. How do you get in the giveaway? Just by leaving comments in the chat right now, and make sure that you're following this channel. And, you know, rumor is that if you click on this link and subscribe there, that you will become more awesome. You will officially be better looking than everybody else that is not subscribed to that channel. And the match is underway. Look at this. Pressure on Kaz right off the bat. Aborticus going in and trying to DPS as much as possible. Franz is taking a lot of damage, but seems to be healing right through it. And Nightmarish is squirrel mode, as well as Aborticus. It's a lot of Dom action going on now. Hikkos is pressuring Franz a lot. It worked last time, and I think he's got his eye on him again to try to make sure it works again this time. Kaz, almost dead. Wow, look at all the low health people going on right now. Kaz now is safe, able to CC Aborticus and get away. It looks like it was a root. Hikkos is still pressuring Franz, whereas Nightmarish is still on Kaz. Oh, Franz is almost dead. Is the Shaman DPS gonna... Yes. Shaman DPS pulls through and Kaz goes down now. Now it looks like a little bit of a duel going on between Hikkos and Aborticus, but Aborticus was, of course, low health and it was way too late. Nightmarish goes down as well. Very good match, guys. So 1-0 for Hikkos right now. Wow, I'm really stoked about the squirrel mount that I just got from Daglar. That was pretty awesome. That made it all worth it. Okay. Alright, the word is that after this match, after this set here, and we get a winner between these two teams, the finals is up then. And with the finals comes the final giveaway of 17,500 credits provided by Daglar. Oh, Rough Raptors, I'm sorry, man. He wanted to do... Oh, man. I'm so sorry, Rough Raptors. Man, you know I show a lot of love towards you, and I deeply apologize for missing that. Rough Raptors wants to give away another prize once we hit 250 viewers, and I believe he said we've already hit it. We just dropped below it afterwards. So, do you want to still do it, Rough Raptors? It's all up to you, man. What was he wanting to give away at 250? Yeah. Well, the thing is that the matches are going to go on whether we do giveaways or not, so. Okay. Yeah, Rough Raptors, it's totally up to you. You give the say-so, man. And please accept my apologies for missing your Oh, so he messaged Kiwi. He did not message me. All right. Rough Raptors, you rock for doing the first giveaway, and even if you don't do the second giveaway, you're still the man. You don't have to give away anything, and I think everybody is very appreciative that you gave the first giveaway like you did. It was very cool of you. Very, very cool. All right, looks like Hikos and is the other team ready or not? Looks like two people over there. Are they all there or not? So this is really cool that this is going down the way it is. It's kind of opened my eyes to what people think is what's viable in 3v3s. I mean, you're kind of seeing the Shaman really pull ahead with Hikos, and people are really trying to do a lot of focused damage with the Rogue stacking. But it seemed not to pull off with the Rogue stacking the way that I thought it would be. They obviously struggled, and it seemed like all the pressure is on the clerics and for people to switch to Defiler spec is seeming to pay off with them be able to pop transformation like they are. Uh-oh, we got another developer here. Developer Pythos. Uh-oh. Look at... All right, guys, you see Pythos there? That is the man whenever it comes to PvP. So he's the one that masterminds all the PvP damage and all that stuff. So, yeah. Oh man, the match is underway. I was gazing at the developer and not paying attention. All right, let's see here. Yeah, some man love. Bordicus at 50% health already. Man, the damage is being really stacked onto him. And Nightmarish looks like he's at half health as well. He's trying to kite away, and now he's at full health once again. And the pet is getting lots of damage put on him, but Franz is kiting around and doing a really good job of healing up and kiting while he's doing it. Hikko seems to be pressuring Franz once again. Is Trunks at 50% health now with Bordicus really putting a lot of pressure on him. Franz is down. Wow, that was a lot of damage. We're really seeing Shaman pull ahead here. Bordicus is at 50% health as well as Trunks. And Nightmarish is about to go down. And he is down with Hikos on him. It's wow, and Bordicus goes down. That was a lot of damage by Shaman. Oh my gosh, that was pretty wild there. So we're seeing a lot of damage coming from Shaman, whereas everybody's kind of struggling to survive through it. He seems to be pressuring all the healers every time, and it's more than they can keep up with, it seems. So how are you guys enjoying this matchups here? Do you think that Shaman is a little bit too strong? Is it, or is it just the person? Is it just the person playing the class, or is it the class? we've always known that Shaman was good 1v1, but now it's looking like it's very obvious it's really good 3v3 right now. Yeah, that's what it's going to be. You're going to have Shaman kind of ruling this thing at the moment, and then tomorrow everybody's going to be Shaman clerics, and then the nerf hits. So thank that man right over there if he continues to pull this off. We're still on our 2-minute cooldown. Everybody getting ready to go. Seems like both teams are ready, it seems. Of course, we got Hikos and friends, and then we have Aborticus and friends over there. Oh, and the go has been signaled. Let's see where the pressure is going to go this time. Seems like Franz is not being pressured at the moment. He seems to be doing all right. Hikos is focusing on Aborticus, which Trunks has taken a lot of damage himself. Franz is freely casting over there, and now Hikos has changed targets to... Oh, he's switching up quite a bit, whereas Trunks is at 50% life, and Aborticus is also taking a lot of damage himself. But the healers are free casting now. Nobody is pressuring the healers like they were. Kaz seems to be taking some damage, as well as Franz, but it's not too much just yet. Hikos is at half health, whereas Trunks is at half health. Basically, half the competitors are at half health, and Franz is going down. Look at the Shaman DPS, and Franz is down. Wow. Now Kaz is at 50% health with a shield up, and Aborticus is as well at half health. Nightmarish has just went down himself. Aborticus is dead as well. It looks like... I'm at a loss for words, guys. That is a 3-0 sweep once again. So the next match will be the finals. And also, that will be whenever we give away 17,500 credits provided by Daglar. Just to correct myself, Pythos is the guy that's responsible for the PvP dimensions. Sorry about the little bit of confusion. He's not the guy dealing with the damage numbers and everything in PvP. It's the PvP dimensions. So thank him if you're really enjoying the show tonight, as well as the people hosting it. Godlike awesomeness. And once again, if you are in the dimension with us and watching these matches, make sure you give this dimension a +1. Make sure that you're showing these guys some love for putting on an awesome event. So, the finals is going to be Viral and Friends against Hikos and Friends. This should be a knockout dragout war right here. This is going to be very, very awesome. The healing on both sides is really, really good, and the DPS is amazing as well. That's how both teams were able to get to the finals now, and
I expect an awesome match, to say the least. So, I'm wondering which specs these guys are going to start out with. We know that Kaz and Hikos and team have been sticking to their normal specs with the Shaman and Cleric Healing. But is Viral going to go Marksman? Is he going to go Stealther? Is Cupcakey going to go Sentinel? Or is she going to go Defiler that she's been doing? So they've been switching it up quite a bit on Viral's team. It's hard to say what they're going to run with this match. Where is the love for Trunks? Trunks is definitely an awesome guy here. Let's go ahead and highlight him, if we can. There's the man right there, Trunks. So is that a little bit of love for Trunks? If I haven't been mentioning him enough, my apologies. He is definitely doing an awesome job. So they're still getting set up here while Mr. Developer Pythos watches his creation in work. All right, the match should be starting just shortly. This is your finale, guys. This is the final bout. Everybody's speculating in the chat whether one team or the next is going to win. It's definitely a split decision on what people think is going to happen. Man, I can't wait for this match to start. I'm kind of curious what the holdup is. I'm wanting to see these guys slug it out now. Come on. Let them loose. Let the dogs out. Let them fight. They're very anxious to get going. You can see them jumping and ready to jump over that rope and go at each other. It is definitely a nail biter waiting for this match to happen. Slayer, I tried to do that. It took down the name frame, so I wasn't able to do it. Oh, there's people chanting for Viral's team to win, and then other people saying that Hikos, Trunks, and Kaz will win in the sweep. I'm kind of curious what is going to happen here if Hikos decides to pressure Cupcakey, because Cupcakey's really good at enduring that kind of pressure a lot of the time. So it's going to be pretty cool to see what's going to happen here. And along with Viral and Naked Stone pressuring The Kaz on the other side. It's going to be a lot of healer pressure, and I'm curious what's going to happen here. Oh, the go has been signaled. What is going to go on here? And right off the bat, we see that Hikos is going for, well, he seems to be pressuring Naked Stone. Kaz taking a lot of damage. He's at 50% health and going down and having to try to save himself. Cupcakey is free casting, not being pressured at all, whereas Naked Stone is about to go down. Oh, the big heal hit right in time. Kaz constantly taking damage from Naked Stone and Viral. They're not letting up on him one bit. At 25% health and trying to kite as best he can and put up shields, Hikos is still pressuring Cupcakey a little bit, but switching up targets quite a bit. Kaz is about to go down. Kaz is down. The healer is down on Hikos' team. Hikos is taking a lot of damage as well as Trunks. Cupcakey is being pressured now. Since the healer is down on Hikos' team, it's obvious they want Cupcakey down to even the odds. Trunks at about 40% health, and Hikos about to go down, and Hikos is dead. Trunks dead as well. Viral's team pulls off the first win. Wow, guys. Very cool match. Very cool match. I did not know how that was going to go at all. I was really anxious to see what would happen. That was an intense match. People were falling down at the 20 and 30% health consistently and able to recover, and it was very cool to watch. Don't forget, guys, after this match, 17,500 credit giveaway to whoever is following the stream and leaving a comment in the chat. We'll do a random name generator and go ahead and pick the winner. And be sure to thank Daglar for the awesomeness he's shown tonight, man. He's really poured it on us with awesome gifts, as well as Rough Raptors and Kiwi also providing awesome gifts for everybody. Show them some love. Go to Kiwi's website and support the PvP Dimensions. And let her know what you would like to see on the website, because she is looking to support whatever you guys think that should be done with it all. Okay, she's wanting to know if you guys would like for her to make it available for you guys to put up your own tournaments on the website. Is that something that you guys would really like to see? Make sure to say in the chat right now to let her know what you guys would like to see, because she's asking right now. Oh boy, this next match. Are they going to change up strategy? I mean, wasn't that the first loss that Hikos and team has suffered? Yeah, that's the first time Kaz has died at all. So, are they going to swap it up, or are they going to think, hey, that was just a fluke, we're going to be able to pull it off? You gotta wonder, you gotta wonder. I should enter a team? Yeah, possibly the next time. Possibly. But if I'm on a team, I'm probably going to fill out the rest of the team with the winners of this tournament because they've got it down pat. Whoever pulls this off has definitely figured out the right strategy. Yes, I'm sure they will do another tournament like this in the future. Just make sure to show these guys some love and let them know that you really appreciate this tournament and that you really liked what they're doing with this PvP dimension. And make sure to watch the forums because that's where they registered all the teams at this last time. Alright guys, make sure that you're checking out the forums because on the PvP forums and all over, they're really showing off a lot of their PvP dimensions as well as putting on tournaments. There's a 2v2 tournament coming up just next week. And there's also other tournaments coming up as well. You guys do not want to miss out on all this because there's lots of prizes to be offered with winning these things. And the match is underway. Naked Stone, line of sight in the enemies, and Kaz being charged right off the bat. Viral and Naked Stone pressuring Kaz as much as possible. Hikos is seeming to switch to Cupcakey now to distribute pressure all around. So far I haven't seen him focus one person yet, but he seems to be on Naked Stone now. Kaz still receiving a lot of pressure. Cupcakey is now a squirrel. So the Dom is the Dom action is out. Trunks pulling it off. And Kaz almost dead. Wow, the pressure is really on him and Hikos is trying to peel, putting the pressure on Viral to try to get him off of Kaz. Trunks is free casting at will. He seems to be picking his target right now. Kaz receiving a lot of damage at about 30% health as Cupcakey is at about 50% and now healed almost all the way up. Kaz still receiving a lot of pressure from Naked Stone. Trunks still free casting, getting a little bit of damage, but it doesn't seem to be too much. Cupcakey being chased by Hikos, and he is making sure to pressure the healer now. Kaz goes down. Wow. Kaz went down. The healer is down on Hikos' team. They're trying to really go after Cupcakey, but Hikos is down now, and they're cleaning up with Trunks. So that is 2-0 for Viral's team. Wow. And please, if you would like to, let's see here. Kalia wants me to let you guys know that /join Demarina at Deepwood for PvP Dimensions, looking for group put together by Kurtic at Deepwood. If you can see the wording then. Yeah, Dim Arena. I said that wrong. As in Dimension Arena at Deepwood. So join that channel for PvP Dimensions so people can put on events. So yeah, you see it in the chat right there. Join that channel and talk to other PvPers about joining PvP events in their dimensions there. Well, it seems to be close to a sweep. The Hikos' team has just dominated all day long. And now they finally seem to have met their match. And
We'll see if they can make the comeback. This next match will be the deciding factor, and Viral's team seems to really have it figured out. And if in future events I do broadcast another event, I will have it easily available to do the giveaways in the future. So, guys, you don't have to wait on the giveaways as much as we did tonight. And my sound will be fixed. You will be able to hear Kiwi again if she is chatting with me the next time. So, all apologies, but we'll figure it out next time. Yes, and the future giveaway coming up after this match is 17,500 credits provided by Daglar. So make sure you stick around for that. We've already given away a lot of awesome stuff. We gave away a toxic hill bug provided by Kiwi. We gave away a $5 credit package provided by Rough Raptors. We gave away three of the... what is it? What was the pet name? Paddles the pet. We gave away three of those. And we've already gave away 17,500 credits to a person. So make sure that you're following the stream and make sure that you are leaving comments in the chat so that you will be included on this giveaway. Because, yeah. Don't be like Dewdrop and not be following whenever the big prize hits you. So, yeah. Oh, the go has been given. Hikos and team and Viral and team now engaging. And let's see who the first targets are going to be. Obviously, Kaz is being pressured once again. Hikos is now pressuring Cupcakey, which he wasn't pressuring her early on in the last match, so this is a definite change in strategy. Kaz at half life, but almost half life in shield. He's making sure to keep himself shielded up really well. Hikos is not leaving Cupcakey, making sure that he's putting as much pressure on her as possible. Trunks free casting, not being messed with one bit, so he is able to tee off all he wants. Kaz now, oh, Kaz goes down. Wow. At 50% life and dead in a matter of a second. Trunks now taking a lot of damage, and Cupcakey being pressured by Hikos. And Trunks goes down. So it's just a matter of sweeping up Hikos now. And Viral's team, 3-0 sweep against Hikos' team. Wow, guys. What a night of fighting here. That was very exciting, and I really didn't see that coming. With the domination Hikos' team was doing before this, there was no way I thought he was going to be swept. And they pulled it off. Viral's team pulled it off. So the winners, you have Viral, Cupcakey, and Naked Stone. A warrior was on the winning team, guys. A warrior. So, very, very awesome event, and stick around. Shortly will be the 17,500 credit giveaway provided by Daglar. Awesome night of fights, guys. Everybody that tuned into this, thank you so much. And especially thank you to teams that took part in this. I mean, you always put something on the line whenever you take a challenge like this. And these guys stepped up to the plate, and every one of them believed that they could win it. If they didn't win, at least they got out there and tried their best. So, very cool. They're probably going to have a good screenshot ceremony. Probably right behind me at the pedestals there.
They're going to have the winners stand there for screenshots. And very, very cool. Make sure you guys are checking out the PvP forums and all that, because there are other tournaments coming up and you do not want to miss them. You want to take part in them if you're not signed up already, because these guys are giving away a lot of stuff in these tournaments. And trust me, I want to be entertained watching you guys fight. So that's what it's all about. It's a lot of fun. Also, guys, last but not least of the promotions, click that link and subscribe to that channel. Rumor is that channel is absolutely amazing with the PvP information, and I hear the guy that runs that channel is an amazing person himself. And it's also a verified fact that if you are subscribed to that YouTube channel, you are better looking than everybody else that is not subscribed to that channel. Kiwi says I'm getting a little bit too far ahead of myself here. Oh, he says that? I didn't know that. I watch a little bit of live streaming of another person, and they say that on a different game. So I will not mention that other game, though. Oh, does he say that? Kiwi's talking to me. If you wonder who I'm replying to. There's one more match, they're saying? What? Is there one more match? What is going on here? All right, yes, there is one more match underway here. Sorry, guys, I thought it was over. And it's the best of seven. Oh, I was off on it. All right, let's see how this is going here. So we got Viral and Naked Stone really putting the pressure to Kaz, and Hikos is really pressuring Cupcakey. So this is what it all comes down to, guys. As you can see, both DPS really not letting up on Kaz whatsoever. Hikos is seeming to try to put as much pressure on the Cupcakey as possible, and Trunks is free casting. Nobody is hitting him, nobody is pressuring him. He is getting to cast all he wants on whoever he wants. Kaz at 20% life, and Kaz goes down. Oh my gosh. Cupcakey at 50% health, and Hikos charging in, but she is just healing up at will. Wow. Okay. Trunks taking some damage back there and goes down. And Cupcakey is about 50% health, but Hikos is the only one alive on his team. And unfortunately, that put the nail in the coffin. Wow. Best of seven, 4-0, that's game. And it was all about how much pressure was being put on the Kaz every time. It seemed like it was just so much damage that he wasn't able to heal through it. And wow, that was just a lot of damage by a rogue and a warrior there. So there you have your winners. This time official. I'm not wrong this time, I believe. So people are asking about Cupcakey, so if I can target her, maybe. There you go. Looks like Sentinel spec. So not Defiler this time. And Cupcakey said only went Sentinel for cleansing through Dom debuffs. So that was the strategy. The counteract Trunks. So, very, very cool matchups, guys. This is really one of the coolest things I've taken part in, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. So I'm sure the award ceremony is going to be happening just shortly. And for first place prizes, what was the first place prizes for these teams? Of course, there was a second place prize as well. And I know that Tryon has also provided codes for the winning team on here. So there is a bonus prize provided by Tryon again for these guys. They are really showering it on us with the prizes and all that stuff. So, special thanks to developer Pythos for putting together the cool PvP dimensions. And we've got some dancing going on back here. There you have your winners, guys. Cupcakey, Viral, and Naked Stone. You got Cleric, Rogue, and Warrior. I know most of you thought that it would be Rogue stacking, probably. Dom would pull it off for all these teams. I seen your posts on the forums. I seen what the speculation was. And this team that is standing on the top podium was not the speculation. So it is definite eye-opener for a lot of people, I believe. Very, very cool. And I'm surprised Viral didn't go Marksman. That's usually what he runs, but I guess the stealthy DPS builds was definitely the way to go for him. Warrior's build. What was the warrior build here for Naked Stone? Well, let's see here. We've got, it looks like he's the Paragon Warlord version. Looks like that's what he ran with, I believe. So, yeah. And, of course, the Sentinel action there. And Viral, there's his buffs. Very cool. So, big props to a local there that helped build this dimension, as well as right there. Hello, Jill. Where is he? Oh, Aloe Vera Gel. Okay, Aloe Gel. I got you. People are correcting me on what I'm saying here because I'm not pronouncing the names right. But this is the other person responsible here, Kalia. And I'm pretty sure I said that one right. So, oh, Torhid is saying that Naked Stone's build was 51 Paragon, 25 Warlord. So that's a bit of a change. And some of you guys were speculating that Paragon would be really good. So much love to these guys for putting on the great event and all the participants. When should we do the giveaway? After the award ceremony here, or? Kiwi says we should give away the credits now. What do you guys think? After the ceremony or right now? Stop stalling. How about now? Okay. All right. So make sure that you're following the stream, and make sure that you leave a comment in the chat there so that we can go ahead and give away 17,500 credits provided by Daglar. And if you win this, I want to see a post on the forum saying Daglar rocks and tell how much you really appreciate everything that he's given everybody.
Okay. Kiwi says that she's not even going to message you guys your prizes until you make a post saying thank you to all the people providing the prizes. So, yeah. All right, there's a lot of people spamming the channel. There's a lot of people in here. How many people do we got watching right now? 241. Not bad for an average afternoon. All right. Yeah. All right, this is a very special occasion this is the very first PvP tournament held in a PvP dimension. It's a big event, that's why we've got Daglar watching, we've got Pythos over there, we've got Kiwi in voice chat with me that you guys can't hear, unfortunately, but, and, of course, the great competition. All right. Stalling. Okay, you guys ready to roll? Here we go. And the winner is Siphon46. Congratulations on 17,500 credits. Provided by Daglar. Make sure you make a forum post saying thank you, Daglar, for 17,500 credits. Everybody's like, boo, no. Yeah, why couldn't Siphon be like Dewdrop and not follow? Very cool, guys, very cool. Thank you to everybody that tuned in, and all the stuff that's went on tonight was provided by a lot of great people. And I think they're going to do the award ceremony. Let's see here. Are they going to do screenshots, or are they doing a yell announcement, or? People are saying, fun to watch, thanks for hosting. Yeah, thanks a lot for the hosting. And all of the lucky paddles winners. 3 times paddles. Did somebody gift Grim a mailbox, please? Yes, I'm neglected because all I do is PvP. I don't even check mail unless it's a guild invite, usually. Yes. I wonder if they're going to have the second place people in third place. Well, I guess there wouldn't be a third place, would there? Not in this event. Thank you, Kiwi. Yeah, everybody that's signing off, and thank you, Daglar. I see you're going away for the night. Thank you so much. You are awesome, dude. You are awesome. Much props to everybody that put this on and the creators of this wonderful PvP dimension. I've been told to tell you guys that just in case she spelled somebody's name wrong, all of the winners, please message Kiwi Dream and just let her know that you were one of the winners and make sure that she got the name spellings right. So, yes, I appreciate it, guys. everybody signing off. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's much appreciated. Viral OP, yeah. Yeah, it looks that way. Kalia, Aloe Gel, and Godlike Awesomeness, salute from Kiwi. You would know if you won one of the giveaways because we spoke about it in the chat. We announced it in the live stream, so... Who won? It was Viral and Friends, which was Viral, Cupcakey, and Naked Stone, which Viral was running, I believe he was running Assassin, it might have been Assassin Nightblade. Cupcakey was mainly running Sentinel with Defiler tossed in whenever needed, and Naked Stone was running Paragon Warlord, with a heavy emphasis in Paragon, with 51 points in Paragon, I'm hearing. So, yeah. A little bit different than the ordinary. And there's Naked Stone. Did I get your spec right there? I appreciate everybody thanking me. I hope I did a good enough job for you guys. It was very fun, put it that way. I can't say that, Cupcakey. I can't say it. Yeah, Naked Stone spec was 51 Paragon, 25 Warlord, 0 Tempest. Yes, be sure to visit Kiwi's website, and also she says, thank you guys for supporting PvP Dimensions. Please send any questions if you need to know anything about building them to kiwi@riftdreamdimensions. And yes, I would love to see PvP Dimensions, especially guild ones. So yeah, build them up, guys. Be creative. And as you can see in this first event, as monumental as it was, there were a few problems. So if you build PvP Dimensions, keep in mind what, you know, the interference and stuff like that. Have that in mind that you want to prevent that if you run an event in your PvP Dimension. And Kiwi says that she has tutorials for you guys to build your PvP Dimensions and to avoid anything that might go wrong, such as this, such as the people interfering like they were. Viral says that he was running Nightblade Sin and 61 Nightblade. Wow. That is pretty awesome right there. So everybody was running specs that I did not think they were going to run. And as you can see, they pulled it off with those specs. Yes, the title gift was very, very cool. Cannot thank you enough. I'm sorry, Rough Raptors. I really apologize for that. As you know, I was trying to give away as many things as I could, everything that was offered up. If I kind of got distracted and missed your chat comment, I apologize. Thank you.
Oh, yeah. Yes, there was actually a lot less DOMs than what was being speculated. A lot of people thought this thing was going to be run by DOMs. It was going to be a lot of mages in here just, you know, draining everybody, and then it would be game over then. And that's not what happened. Not what happened. We've seen Shaman really excel. And then we also seen a little bit different specs from Rogues and Warrior there that really pulled ahead. Please nerf Viral, please. Cupcakey, your movement is OP. Very true. What were the prizes? Just curious. Are you talking about for first prize for winning the tournament or the prizes that we gave away in the stream? The things that we gave away in the stream were we gave away Toxic Hellbug provided by Kiwi. We gave away a $5 credit package offered by Rough Raptors, and he tried to give away more stuff, but I missed it. And we had three Paddles the Pet giveaways provided by Daglar. We had two giveaways of 17,500 credits provided by Daglar. Yeah. We gave away a lot of stuff. I think that was all. That was a lot of things. I might have missed something. Yeah. Yeah, Hikos was the main DPS on his team. So, yeah. He did a really good job of applying a lot of pressure. I'm not sure if the award ceremony has already taken place or if they're still doing it. I'm not real certain. I believe it's already over and they're basically just wrapping up and everybody's leaving the dimension now, as this is the after party, so to say. So a lot of people are going home for the night. Yep. All right, guys, I think that's the wrap-up for us as well. I think with the tournament over and all the giveaways done, it's night-night for everybody. So I hope everybody enjoyed it, and please thank everybody that was involved in this and let them know that we really appreciate all the work they've done. And like I said, Kiwi is serious about, you've got to make posts on the forums thanking Daglar, Kiwi, Rough Raptors, and everybody that made this happen. You know, you guys have got to thank Godlike Awesomeness and everybody involved in it for putting on this event, or there will be no prizes at all. I'm joking. You do not have to send her. You do not have to post on the forums like that. So, all kidding aside, click that link, subscribe. Make sure that you go there for all of your PvP needs. There's lots of war fronts, lots of build guides, and all kinds of goodness on that YouTube channel there, and I think you guys will enjoy it. All right, we're going to go ahead and sign off on this stream. Thanks everybody for tuning in. All right, take care, all.